Welcome to all of our SEM students. Today we are going to see about diffraction at single slit. It is one of the wave phenomena in our optics lesson. Optics, we have two sub branches, ray optics and wave optics. In that wave optics part, wave phenomena are explaining that one of that phenomena is diffraction. That diffraction phenomena can be verified by using a single slit. Slit is nothing but narrow opening part. Through that narrow opening part, we are passing a waves, that is light waves. We know that light is one of that electromagnetic wave which has a wavelength in the order of 10⁻⁷ meters. In the order of 10⁻⁷ meters. For making a diffraction, what condition we required means obstacle size should be in that order of wavelength of that wave. So like that, here we are going to take on a slits opening as well as the edges of the obstacles are in that order of 10⁻⁷ meters. For studying that diffraction in our single slit, there we are using a monochromatic source. That monochromatic source, if it is operated, it can be emitted light in all directions. But we want to produce a parallel beam of light. Parallel beam of light. That purpose, we are using one of the convex lens. So we are going to see that sorting of that diffraction effect experiment. Initially, we required source of monochromatic light. That source is a point source. If a point source of the light is operated, monochromatic light is operated, it can be emitted light radiation in all directions. But we required a parallel beam of light. So that purpose, we are going to take on a convex lens, considered as a lens 1. To that lens 1 focus, we are placing our source of monochromatic light. If the source is focus of this lens 1, then that light from that source, if it is falls on that convex lens, then the emergent lights are moves in a parallel. Emergent lights are moves in a parallel. We are producing a parallel beam of monochromatic light. This parallel beam of monochromatic light is going to make to incident on the single slit. But how we are placing that single slit means, to the direction of that parallel beam of light, perpendicularly we are placing. We are placing the slit. The plane of that slit is perpendicular to that parallel beam of light. If that parallel beam of light is entered through that slit, at the edges of that obstacles, there we get a diffraction. And another concept we have, wave theory. What is given in our wave theory means, these all points going to act as a source for the wavelets which are producing in that right side of our slit. So that slits upper thing is taken as a A, and lower we are mentioning a B, and the middle of that point can be represented as a C. Anyhow, this parallel beam of monochromatic light is going to normally incident to that slit, then there we are producing a diffraction pattern. That diffraction pattern want to produce in our screen, That's why we are placing the screen at one particular distance. That distance between that single slit and the screen can be taken as a D, as well as width of the slit. This represents as a small a, that is distance between A to B is taken as a A. So what is the distance between A to C and C to B? That is equal, because we are mentioning that a C point in that middle of that slit. That's why AC equal to BC or CB equal to A by 2. The total distance is A, then half a distance A by 2. Anyhow, these light waves are going to make diffraction in that single slit and produce a diffraction pattern. That diffraction pattern, how we are getting for that purpose? We are drawing a perpendicular line to our screen. From that point C, we are drawing the line. We consider that point as a O. Called as a center of that screen. At the center of the screen, we want to produce the diffracted waves. For that purpose, we are placing a convex lens. Consider as a L2 lens. The rays which are moves parallel to the principal axis of that convex lens is going to converge at that point O. That is meaning of that waves are going to make an interference. So we know that if the rays, all the rays are moves in a straight without bending, their covering paths are, path length is equal. The rays comes from that slit to travel that point O should be equal length. If the length of the path is equal for all the wave, means there we are not having a no path difference between that each and every wave. If we are not having a path difference between each and every wave, then in phase interaction, interference is happened at that point O. If in phase interference is happened, means that type of interference is called as a constructive interference. That's why the rays which are parallel to the principal axis of this convex lens and moves directed in that direction of that incident ray going to converge at that point O and produce the maximum intensity at the center of that screen. That's why that point maximum intensity is called as central maximum. then the central maximum intensity is very high as compared to the other maximum. That's why their amplitude as well as the intensity can be traced here as like this. Like that it is produced. It is a central maximum. This can be taken with tau, that is linear with tau, central maximum. Linear with tau, central maximum. Anyhow, up to this portion, the waves which are comes from our slits are in phase interaction. There is no path difference. Path difference between each and every wave is zero. So that's why we are producing a central maximum. If that central maximum is completed, there we have minimum intensity. That is the first minimum intensity. There we are placing a point P. We are going to taken that point as a P, which is the end of that central maximum. The point P is taken in our screen, which is the end of that central maximum. That's why that point may be called as a geometrical shaded region of central maximum. Geometrical shaded region of central maximum. Anyhow, that point from our such a minimum intensity. Anyhow, in this point, if you want to produce a minimum intensity or maximum intensity, that depends upon that waves which are comes from our slit should be having a certain path difference. If the point P is a minimum intensity, means waves path difference are in the order of lambda by 2. In the order of lambda by 2. If the path difference is lambda by 2, the two waves, if it makes interference, means destructive interference is happened. If we have a destructive interference, then the intensity is minimum. Intensity is minimum. For finding that point P, minimum intensity, we want to rotate the lens. That lens principal axis should be in that line joining of that point P to that C. This lens should be rotated and its principal axis should be in that line joining of C to P. Like that, if you rotate it, that principal axis is drawn that line C to P, to that parallelly rays are comes from each and every point of our slit. Each and every point of our slit that we are going to take, and that rays going to converge and produce the intensity of the diffracted wave at that point. But that rays which are interfered to produce a minimum intensity, that rays here making certain angle theta with that incident direction. Otherwise we can say normal to the plane of the slit makes theta angle. Not only this end deviated ray, all points deviated rays makes angle theta. If these all rays are making angle theta, means these rays are parallel with each other. Rays which are making certain angle and parallel with each other, so are going to fall on that convex lens, and that all converge to produce the interference pattern at a point P. There we can produce a either maximum intensity or minimum intensity depends upon the path difference. If the path difference is in the order of lambda by 2, there we can produce a dark. If the path difference is in the order of lambda, bright can be produced. Both the conditions we are going to see for finding the intensity at a point P, whether it may be a minimum intensity and as well as the maximum intensity. First of all, we are going to see the minimum intensities. So at this point, if we want to produce a minimum intensity, we want to take on certain basic ideas. What basic ideas we want to take on means, here we have only one slit, not having a many number of slits. That's why we want to imagine and take on certain idea that single slit is going to divided into much smaller parts. Why we are saying want to divide into much smaller part means, already this slit size is in the order of 24 minus 7 meter. So that should be divided to study about the diffraction patterns, either for the maximum intensity and also minimum intensity. Now for the both the cases, first, what basic idea we want to take on to find the minimum intensity at a point P means, we want to divide this slit into even number of parts. Why we are taking the even number of parts means, one part with another part, path difference is lambda by 2. If one part path difference with that another part is path difference lambda by 2 means, if the two are interacted, what may be happen? Destructive interference is produced. That's why for producing a minimum intensity at a point P, we are taken the idea that slits total width is going to divide into even number of parts. Then only one cancelled with another to produce a minimum intensity. So how we can produce maximum intensity at a point P means, that a single slit should be divided into odd number of parts. Suppose we are divided into three parts. One part with another part. First part with the second part, if they are having a path difference lambda by 2, they two are cancelled. Remaining one part we have. That part's intensity can be produced at that point P. Then we have a bright, their maximum intensity. There we have a maximum intensity. So that's why for studying that diffraction pattern, minimum and maximum intensity, we want to divide the slits either odd number of parts and even number of parts. If you divide the single slit into odd number of parts, at that screen we can produce a maximum intensity. One can be not cancelled, others can be cancelled. But if you divide the slits in an even number of parts, one cancel with the another, and totally we have pairs, we have that pairs are cancelled, produce a minimum intensity. Produce a minimum intensity. Now we are going to see about the condition of P for the first minimum. What condition we are going to see means, condition for P to be a first minimum. At that point, first minimum condition we are going to see. okay, condition for point P to be a first minimum on that screen. So that purpose, minimum means how that single slit is going to divide even number of parts. So here that single slit is going to divide into two part. This beginning point may be considered as a A, this is considered as a B, center can be taken as a, center point can be taken as a C. The normal lines are this for that slit. So that diffracted rays are deviated from that normal certain angle. We have split a single slit into two equal parts, even number of parts, even number of parts. Then the rays come from each and every points are deviated in a certain angle, that all rays are parallel. Then another concept is going to implement here, corresponding points. So which are called as a corresponding points means, now you know that total width of the slit is A. Half a width is taken as A by 2. From A point and C point, waves come to make a interference means, suppose if they make a interference means, their path difference lambda by 2, then it will get a destructive interference. Destructive interference. And minimum intensity can be produced. That is we are going to study. Which are called as a corresponding point means, the points in our slits which are A by 2 distance, that points are corresponding point. We can call A and C is one set of corresponding point. Same time C and B also one set of corresponding points, which are the distance of that points equal to A by 2. Not only that A and C, C and B are corresponding points. After that A, if you take on one point, that point is going to act as a corresponding point to that another point, this point. The points which are in that total slit, points which are distance of A by 2, that points are corresponding points. But in our diagram, one pair is AC, another pair is BC. Not only that, all the points in our slits which are in that A by 2 distance, that are called as a corresponding points. That are called as a corresponding points. So anyhow, we are going to take that two successive corresponding point. The two successive corresponding point is A and C. The rays comes from the two successive corresponding points having a certain path difference lambda by 2 to make a destructive interference. For finding the path difference, we want to draw the normal line. Normal line. We know that this line makes a theta angle with that. Similarly, this is a slit alone. For finding that angle purpose, this also theta. This also theta. Want to find this length. This length is path difference between that two successive corresponding point rays. If we take an AC and it is N, consider the triangle ACN. The theta's opposite side is act as a path difference. That's why we are going to take an sine theta is equal to, what is that? Opposite side by hypotenuse side. So that's why sine theta is equal to, opposite side is which one? Consider as a CN divided by hypotenuse side is AC. Then path difference. Path difference between A and C equal to, that is CN equal to AC sin theta. What is that? Length of that AC means, that is nothing but equal to A by 2. A by 2 sin theta. Totally path difference between that waves which are comes from the two corresponding points, successive corresponding point. If this path difference is equal to lambda by 2, it will give the minimum intensity. Minimum intensity. That is the first minimum intensity that we can take on A by 2 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. What is that means? A by 2 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2 is a condition for obtaining a first minimum. Obtaining a first minimum. So anyhow, if you cite out the 2 and 2, we will get that A sin theta is equal to lambda. This is for which one? First minimum condition. Next, we want to find the second minimum condition for P to B, the point P to B, second minimum. So already for a first minimum, single slit is going to divide into two equal parts. For minimum, we want to divide the slits into even number of parts only. So already we divide into two. Now that single slit want to divide it into four equal parts. One full length slit is A. If it is divided into four, their length of each part is A by 4. Then there we have path difference between the corresponding points, between the two successive corresponding points. That can be taken as similar to the top derivation of that first minimum. Therefore, that second minimum, A by 4 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. This is the condition for obtaining a second minimum at that point P. At that point P, to obtain a second minimum, condition is A by 4 sin theta equal to lambda by 2. Because we have divided each slit, that is a full slit, into four equal parts. That's why we are taken A by 4 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. If you simplify it, we'll get that A sin theta is equal to 2 lambda. A sin theta is equal to 2 lambda is for second minimum condition. Second minimum condition. Like that, for condition for third minimum condition. What condition here we want to take on to form a third minimum at that point B? That the total slit width is going to divide into six equal parts, and from the successive corresponding point, rays, diffracted rays, path difference we want to calculate. Similar to the top, first there the path difference of that third minimum is a by 6 sin theta equal to lambda by 2. A by 6 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. If you simplify it, we will get a sin theta is equal to 3 lambda. It is the condition for third minimum. Ask like that, condition for nth minimum. For P to be a nth minimum. Nth minimum. So that purpose, the slit should be divided into 2n parts. So their path difference can be taken as a by 2n sin theta if it is equal to in that order of lambda by 2. In that order of lambda by 2, we can obtain nth minimum at the point P. That is lambda by 2. That is lambda by 2. If you simplify it, we will get a sin theta is equal to n lambda. A sin theta is equal to n lambda. It is condition for P as a nth minimum point. There n is the natural number. The values can be taken, n is equal to 1, 2, 3, goes on. Not put 0 for that, not taken that n value is 0, because no central minimum, only that first order minimum, second order minimum, third order minimum, as like that we have. So that's why in our single slit, nth minimum formula is a sin theta is equal to n lambda. A is nothing but a width of a slit. Theta is the angular diffraction. N is the order and lambda is the wavelength. Similarly, we want to form maximum at that point P. For that purpose, how we want to split our slit means hard number of parts we want to split. So we are going to see condition for P to B. First maximum. Condition for P to be a first maximum. How many equal parts we want to divide means 3 equal parts. That slit should be divided into 3 equal parts. So each parts width is a by 3. So according our principle for finding the path difference, a by 3 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. That is, if you divide the slit into 3 equal parts, first part and the second parts, path difference is lambda by 2, means that 2 are cancelled. Third part is a uncancelled part. That part of a source is going to produce a light intensity at that point of first maximum. Point of first maximum. Anyhow, a by 3 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. Then you rearrange that, we will get a sin theta is equal to 3 lambda by 2. So for condition for that first maximum is a sin theta is equal to 3 lambda by 2. Next we are going to see second maximum. Okay. Next we see that condition for P to be second maximum. So total slit width is width of the slit. Slit is equal to A. Now already for that first maximum we divide that single slit into three parts. Now we are going to split into five equal parts. A is divided into five equal parts. So each part's length is A by 5, and between the two successive corresponding point diffracted ray, path difference can be taken as A by 5 sin theta. If it is equal to lambda by 2, in that first two cancelled, third and fourth also cancelled, and the fifth is uncancelled. That uncancelled portion can be produced here, bright at that point B. So that's why we have taken A by 5 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. From this we rearrange that A sin theta equal to 5 by 2 lambda. This is condition for second maximum. Then we will see condition for third maximum. P to be third maximum. For forming a third maximum, single slit has divided into seven equal parts. That's why A by 7 sin theta equal to lambda by 2. In a seven parts, first six parts are cancel one with the other, which are having a path difference lambda by 2. But seventh part is uncancelled part that will produce a bright at that point P. At that point P. That's why A by 7 sin theta is equal to lambda by 2. From this we get that A sin theta is equal to 7 by 2 lambda. 7 by 2 lambda. This is the third maximum condition obtained at that point P. If we want to find the nth maximum, we want to obtain the nth maximum at that point P, what we are going to take on that means the nth part we required means nth maximum we required means how many equal parts we want to divide, 2n plus 1 number of parts we want to divide. So we say that condition for P to be nth maximum, where single slit to be divided into A should be divided into two n plus one number of parts. So path difference can be taken as A by 2n plus 1 into sin theta. If it is equal to lambda by 2 means one part is not cancelled, all other parts are cancelled. So from this we will get that equation A sin theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. This is the condition for nth maximum formed at that point P. Nth maximum formed at that point P. Then n is integer. There are the values. N can be taken as 0, 1, 2, 3. Is the n value for that bright. Why we are taken that is a 0 means we have the central maximum. That's why we have started that value is 0, 1, 2, 3. For a minimum, You are not having that central missing minimum. That's why their n value is taken from 1, 2, 3. So that a sin theta into 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2 is condition for obtaining maximum at that point P. And another thing is for a condition for obtaining a nth minimum at the point P is a sin theta is equal to n lambda. A sin theta is equal to n lambda. This is the concept we have studied in our diffraction at that single slit. If waves are incident parallel to that single slit, rays which are false on that slit, they are makes diffraction. That diffracted rays are produced in that right side of our slit, and that diffraction rays are going to converge to form a diffraction pattern on the screen. That diffraction pattern has central maximum at the end of the central maximum, first minimums above and below the central maximum, we have the first minimum. After the first minimum, there we have a first maximum. Then at the end of that first minimum, above and below, there we have a second minimum. After that first maximum, we get the second minimum. Alternately, it is forming bright and dark fringes. Which one has the maximum intensity means central bright has the maximum intensity. All other brights are reducing the intensity because we are dividing many number of parts. One part only produces. If you move the order, number of parts division, that is a single slit is divided in many parts. That's why intensity of that diffracted pattern is not remain same for all the orders. Only that central maximum having maximum intensity, then it is rapidly decreasing. And thank you for all.